In this video, I'm going to tell you some things you probably do not know about Generative Fill and also the Remove tool. I'm going to show you when you should be using each, and then I'm going to give you tips that nobody talks about, how you shouldn't use them. Then we're going to look at resolution, and I'm going to prove to you that some people are overreacting about the way they deal with resolution inside of Generative Fill. I think you're going to find this video really interesting. So when should we be using Generative Fill versus the other tools? Well, here's the short answer is if you need to generate something, then you should be using Generative Fill. Let me demonstrate. So look at this picture of the woman in the bike. If I want to remove the whole thing, I could use non-generative tools because it has what it needs in this image. If I would just want to remove the woman, then we're going to have problems because it needs to generate part of the bike. Let's demonstrate. So let's go to the Remove tool. And I'm going to create a new layer, and then we're going to sample all layers so we can work non-destructively on this. So the advantages of the Remove tool, number one, there's no resolution limitations. Number two, it works faster. Number three, you don't need to be on the internet to do it. It works locally. Number four, it does not use generative credits. So let's apply it right now. So I'm just going to go across here, and I want to make sure that I'm covering this entire bicycle and person. So let's just go over it. It's very important with this that you completely recover all the areas that you want to remove. All right, so I'm doing this in one stroke. I'm going to release it. It's going to start applying. Because it's working on a bigger area, it's going to take a little bit longer. But look at that. Does a pretty good job of removing it. Yes, I could go in and I could fix up some of these bricks. All I would have to do is just paint over them. And you can keep doing it to get it perfect. But let me undo this. There's another thing to be aware of, by the way. If I have remove after each stroke turned off, it won't apply until I hit the check mark. And let's do that this time. So what happens if I go to remove just the person from the bike? All right, we've completely covered her. And if I want to take away from some areas, so if I can refine it, I can hold the Alt or the Option key and I can clean that up. Now, this is one of the advantages in having remove after each stroke turned off. It gives you the ability to go in here and refine it because we want to preserve some of the things like the parts in the bike, etc. All right, let's apply this now. We're going to hit the check mark. So we already discussed the benefits. Here's the downside of it is it does not do a good job of generating things that are not already in the image, such as the frame of the bicycle. Plus, there's no variations to use. So let's undo this. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. So let's blow up one big myth about a way to use Generative Fill, and that would be to use Select Subject. It doesn't work well. Let me show you why. Let's go to the Object Selection, and we're going to choose Object Finder, and then Roll Over. And let's do that. We're going to select the person. Let me turn the object finder off again, but we've basically selected her. We need to refine that a little bit. Let me do that here quickly with the lasso tool. Just going to hit the shift key to add to that selection. Make sure we've selected the whole subject. Now we definitely need to expand it beyond her. So we're going to choose select, modify, expand. And 20 pixels should be enough. Yeah, that's given us a nice border. Now, I've seen people use it this way or talk about using it this way, and it's not very good. I'll show you why. Let's hit Generative Fill. Leave it blank because what we want to do is remove it. And we're going to hit Generate. Okay, this is what happens. It is generating another person. All three variations here, we've got a new person being generated. Let's undo this. Why? Why is it doing that? And why is that? Well, if you check out another one of my videos, the number one thing that influences a selection is the shape of the selection. Because it's such a perfect silhouette of a person, it thinks we want to create a person. So let's take that selection off. And now I'm just going to use the lasso tool here, and I'm just going to make a rougher selection around the shape of the person. Just covering all the important areas. But it's not going to look so much like a person, right? Now if I apply Generative Fill, boom, we don't have a person anymore, we have a removal. All right, let's talk about another thing that kind of irks me a little bit, And that is resolution. Yes, it is true that it only generates at 1024 by 1024. But that does not mean that this is useless in images or even selections larger than that. Let me show you what I mean. So we're going to create a selection and we'll make it a fixed selection. And let's do fixed size. We'll put in 1024 by 1024. This here is the size of the generation, right? So I can generate it 1024 by 1024. So if I generate in this area, it's going to be full resolution. Let's take the fixed size off. Let's go to normal. And this time I'm going to go really large. I'm going to go larger than that area. And I don't really care what gets generated in here. Let's just use generative fill and we're going to generate it because I want to show you something. Okay. So here's the thing. Let's zoom into 100%. Let's figure out where this selection is. Ah, there we go. This is where it's generated. If you look, you'll notice on that side in here, let's go even closer. See how the resolution is lower. Look at that. I'll just make the selection there. See where that changes right there. Yep, you can see the resolution here is softer. And so a lot of people say, hey, I can't use generative fill because that selection is softer and it looks really bad. But here's the thing a lot of people don't think about. What size are you outputting your image? And now if you're working on the beta version of Photoshop, you can actually click on the generator and you have the option to enhance the image. I've done a separate video about that, but to prove my point here, we're not going to do that in this video. We're going to just use it as it was generated. If I'm going to do this for social media and I'm going to choose export save for web, and then I set this to 1920, which is going to be, you know, as big as you're going to use for social media or anything like that, 1920 by 1080. So now tell me without telling me that you can't really notice the resolution difference. Because you can't zoom in any higher. So I see people all the time, they're complaining and they're outputting it at such a low resolution that you can't see the resolution mismatch. And of course, if you are outputting to print and large format, yes, this could be an issue. But when people are sharing their images to social media or putting them on the web, sometimes they're overreacting. And I know where a lot of this, and this kind of really irks me, there's some commentators, I'm not going to say who they are, that really want clickbait and they hype this stuff up and they get people all kind of up in arms about stuff that's really not an issue. I think it's about time we need to stop swallowing camels and spitting out gnats and just focusing on creating art. Anyway, all right. Little bit of a vent there from me. Hey, if you learned anything new in this video, let me know, drop a comment underneath. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. Till next time, I'll see you at the cafe.